So, we are going back to the moon. NASA has been preparing vigorously for the second Artemis mission ever since a successful splashdown of Artemis 1 on December 11th of 2022 in Pacific Ocean of Baja California. Artemis 2 will carry an already selected crew of astronauts to the moon's vicinity for the first time since 1972. No moon landing will occur, unfortunately, and in order for the second Space Launch System rocket to launch, every partner and contributor involved must finish constructing and sending their essential systems, like the European Service Module, which supplies the Orion spacecraft with primary power and propulsion until it is discarded according to the mission plan. But compared to the first Artemis journey, Artemis 2 seems to be taking a much easier trajectory plan to reach the moon, similar to the Apollo missions. A simple figure 8 or a free return trajectory will be performed compared to a crazy balancing between moons Lagrange point 1 and 2 of the Artemis 1. So why are we not taking such weird route again, and what are the key and still unique takeaways of the Artemis 2 flight profile that we have to understand? Subscribe to the channel and let's talk about it! This is Adventures in Space. First, let's understand the complexity as well as the necessity of such a route for the Artemis 1 mission. Its truly unique trajectory took 26 days to complete compared to, let's say, Apollo 8's 6-day journey. The reason for this unconventional path lies in the physics and energy requirements of reaching the moon. Actual landing on the moon demands a tremendous amount of energy, even more so than landing on Mars, despite the moon being much closer. The goal of Artemis 1 was to test the systems of the Orion capsule while orbiting the moon to collect the necessary data on energy consumption. Now, let's dive even deeper and say that the key factor in planning the route to the moon is delta V, which measures the change in velocity required for a spacecraft to complete its journey. Although different rockets may travel the same route, the energy required to achieve the same delta V can vary based on factors such as rocket's weight and engine efficiency. So, in the case of Artemis 1, NASA planned a novel approach of Orion's journey. Instead of a direct insertion into lunar orbit like Apollo, Orion aimed for a distant retrograde orbit around the moon, a path that had never been attempted before. This orbit involved orbiting the moon at a distance and moving in the opposite direction of its orbit around Earth, spending equal time at Lagrange points 1 and 2 to maintain balance without expending additional fuel. To reach this orbit, Orion took advantage of a gravity assist. Approaching the moon from a specific side allowed the moon's gravity to slow down the spacecraft and alter its velocity. Orion used this technique to reduce its speed and reach an elliptical orbit with an apoapsis of 70,000 km, the intended height. This gravity assist saved a significant amount of fuel. However, one more burn was necessary to circularize its orbit and achieve the distant retrograde orbit. The distant retrograde orbit allowed Orion to delve deeper into space than the Apollo missions. It offered a 12-day lunar orbit, extendable to 24 days if desired, providing ample time for testing Orion's systems. Returning to Earth required breaking free from the moon's gravity. Orion performed a reverse gravity assist, slowing down near the lunar surface and executing a final burn to set a trajectory back to Earth. The Oberth effect influenced the timing of this burn, maximizing velocity by capitalizing on the highest gravitational pull at the closest approach. Now, here's the thing. These maneuvers, utilizing gravity assists and carefully timed burns, are vital components of spaceflight in order to establish the lunar gateway correctly. NASA is saying that it is a crucial component for the Artemis generation missions as a whole, and this station will allow humans to achieve remarkable efficiency of landing on the moon. We have a whole video about the lunar gateway in this channel if you're interested, but let's now discuss the trajectory of the Artemis 2 mission. Why is it going to be different? To start, the flight profile for this mission is referred to as a hybrid free return trajectory. The main difference is that Orion this time will perform several maneuvers to increase its orbit around Earth, and eventually place the crew on a trajectory that will naturally bring them back to Earth after flying by the Moon, thanks to Earth's gravity, of course. Initially, the SLS rocket will launch Orion into space, separate from the rocket, and position Orion in an orbit around Earth. Following a demonstration of proximity operations, control of Orion will be handed back to mission controllers at Johnson Space Center. The crew will spend the remaining orbit verifying the performance of the spacecraft systems in the space environment. They will change from wearing the Orion crew survival system suits they wear for launch and continue the in-space mission in regular clothes until they put their suits back on to prepare for re-entry into Earth's atmosphere and recovery from the ocean. While still near Earth, the crew will assess the performance of the life support systems, which are essential for generating breathable air and removing carbon dioxide and water vapor produced when astronauts breathe, speak, or exercise. The long orbital period around Earth provides an opportunity to test the systems during exercise periods when the crew's metabolic rate is highest and during sleep periods when the metabolic rate is lowest. That transition between the suit mode and cabin mode in the life support system, as well as its performance during exercise and sleep, will confirm the full range of capabilities and readiness for the lunar flyby part of the mission. Orion will also check the communication and navigation systems to ensure they are prepared for the journey to the Moon. During Orion's travel to and around the Moon, Mission Control will rely on the Deep Space Network to communicate with the astronauts, transmit imagery to Earth, and command the spacecraft. After completing the necessary procedures, Orion will perform the next propulsion maneuver known as the Translunar Injection, or TLI burn. The service module will provide the final push required to set Orion on a course toward the Moon. With the initial configuration propulsion stage, or ICPS, having done most of the work to place Orion into a high Earth orbit. The TLI burn will send the crew on a 4-day outbound trip, taking them around the far side of the Moon, where they will create a Figure 8 path spanning over 230,000 miles from Earth. Before Orion begins the return journey, the astronauts will continue evaluating the spacecraft systems, including demonstrating Earth departure and return operations, practicing emergency procedures, and testing their radiation shelter, among other activities. The Artemis II crew will travel approximately 6,400 miles beyond the far side of the Moon, with a return trip of about 4 days. The mission is expected to last slightly over 10 days. Instead of relying on propulsion for the return, this fuel-efficient trajectory utilizes the gravity field of the Earth and Moon. This ensures that after traveling around the far side of the Moon, Orion will be naturally pulled back by Earth's gravity for the free return part of the mission. The mission will conclude with a crewed re-entry and splashdown, marking the final step before sending humans to land on the Moon. In summary, the variations in trajectory between Artemis 1 and Artemis 2 serve the purpose of testing different methods for the spacecraft. The implementation of a free return trajectory in Artemis 2 also helps reduce the mission duration and converse resources required to support the crew and the spacecraft. Moreover, Artemis 2 places a stronger emphasis on testing the life support systems, and opting for the trajectory used during the Apollo era for the Orion capsule provides an added assurance of a safe return journey. Let us know in the comment section down below what other factors you think will play a crucial role in Artemis 2 mission, and please don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. We do 4 essays every week in relevant topics with everything aerospace industry related and much more. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.